Hello and welcome back. I'm in a TV. We're still alive, right? Okay. Is this a dream?
No, I'd say the pain I'm feeling right now is very real.
Real?
Whoa.
What now? Did you wet your pants?
No, stupid. Look around.
Is this a studio? All this fog. Or is it smoke? There's no place like this in Inaba, is there?
Hell no. But man, this place is huge.
What are we gonna do?
Let's go home.
Good plan. Look, we need to get home and... Huh? Wait a minute. Which way did we come in from? I don't see a way in or out.
What? That can't be right. How could that be?
I don't know. Don't ask me. I can't take this anymore. I want to go home.
Okay, so how?
We're doomed!
What? Don't say stuff like that! Let's calm down and think about this.
We're all gonna die!
So we need to find a way out.
Is there really a way out of here?
We got in, so we must be able to get out some.
That's true, but...
If there's no exit, we're trapped, so let's cross our fingers and look around.
What is this place? It feels different from where we were before.
It looks like we're in some kind of building, but... Damn, this fog's so thick I can hardly see.
Are you sure we're not wandering farther away?
I can't be positive, but we've got to trust our instinct a little.
I know, but...
It seems that there's no choice for now but to continue onward.
Hey, is it me or is the fog lighter here? No service. What a surprise.
Can you guys slow down a little? It's hard enough to see where you're going. Huh? What the?
Ooh.
It's a dead end. There's no exit.
Emphasis on dead.
Keeps getting creepier and creepier the further we go. I can't hold it any longer! My bladder's gonna explode!
Yosuke, what are you doing?
I gotta let it out before I piss my pants!
You're going here? Oh, you have gotta be kidding!
Turn around! I can't go if everyone's watching! I can't do it. It's all your fault if my bladder bursts.
Like I care. Anyways, what's with this room? Check out these posters. Their faces are all cut out. Someone must really hate this person.
Dude, this chair and rope? That kind of arrangement is never good. It's tied in a noose. Is this a scarf?
Come on! Let's go back to where we came from and look somewhere else for an exit.
Hey, I think I've seen that poster before.
Who cares? Let's go! I'm sick of this place. And I'm not feeling so good.
Now that you mention it, me too.
Your body does feel heavy. Could it be due to this place's oppressive atmosphere?
Alright, let's go back. I'm seriously starting to feel sick.
Phew! We finally made it back here. Wait, what's that?
There's something over there.
It's a bear!
What is this thing? A monkey? A bear?
What in the world? That's what I want to know. Who are you guys?
It talked! What are you? You want to fight?
Don't yell at me like that.
The bear is cowering in fear. Maybe it should be better to ask him nicely. Is this a dream?
Dream? What are you talking about? I've always lived here. It's real, see?
You live here?
If I was you guys, I'd hurry back to the other side. Someone's been throwing people in here. It's a big headache.
Huh? Throwing people in? What are you talking about?
I don't know who's doing it. I just want them to think before they go doing things like that.
Hey, what's your problem? What gives you the right to yell at us like that? What are you? Where are we? What the heck is going on here?
I already told you. Anyways, you should hurry back.
I'm not quite a wall of protection for you.
What it comes down to is, you want us to get out of here, right?
Well, so do we. We just don't know how, damn it!
That's why I'm saying I'll let you out.
Like I keep saying, we don't know where the frickin' exit... Wait, what? What the hell?
Where did those TVs come from?
Okay, now go, get out of here. I'm a busy bear.
What's going on now? Whoa! Hey, what are you doing?
Stop pushing!
And we return. Hopefully nobody was around to see that. Dude, these kids just totally fell out of a TV.
Huh? Is this?
Did we make it back?
Attention shoppers! Our daily limited time sale will now begin at the side dish area on the first floor. Why not try the delicious fresh produce Juness picked for you this morning as your side dish for dinner tonight? All ages are invited to take advantage of this incredible bargain.
Even one-year-olds! Yay!
It's already that late?
Looks like we were in there for quite a while.
That's right. Now I remember where I saw that poster before. Look over there.
What's up now? Hey, you're right. They're the same. I couldn't tell before without the face, but it was Misuzu Hiragi. She's been all over the news lately. Something about her husband having an affair with that announcer lady who died the other day.
Hey, so does that mean that weird room we saw? Could it be related to that Yamano lady's death? Now that I think about it, there was that creepy noose hanging from the ceiling.
Yeah, stop! No more! We gotta stop talking about this. I'm gonna wipe what happened today from my brain. I don't think my poor heart can take anymore.
I'm feeling a chill, too. Let's go home. I wanna lie down and rest.
After school, the evening!
Hey, welcome home.
Flop. You still feel sluggish. Those are giant ramen bowls.
I doubt you'd know. But have you heard anything about a student named Saki Konishi?
She discovered the body. People feel sorry for her. She wasn't at school today.
Oh, I see. Well, to be honest, we got a call from her family. She's disappeared. We've got people looking for her, but she hasn't been found yet. Oh, work just keeps piling up.
And now, more on the case still casting a shadow over the foggy town of Inaba. Not long ago, television announcer Mayumi Yamano was found dead in the small town. Up until now, her whereabouts prior to her death had been unknown. But the police investigation has found that she had been staying in the region's famous Amagi Inn.
The Amagi Inn? It's the inn that Yukiko's family runs! Ba-da-bup.
She had apparently been staying there alone. Perhaps she was taking a vacation to recover from her ordeal?
I'm so tired. Everything's funny to me.
Oh yes, the Amagi Inn. Their hot springs are first rate. The manager's teenage daughter also works there, and it's rumored that she'll take over the inn this spring. If that happens, she'll be one of the youngest managers on record. I should book another trip there.
I see. Moving along, it's time for the weather report. The rain has begun to subside. From now until morning, heavy fog warnings will be in effect in the Inaba region. Visibility will be severely reduced, so please be careful if you plan on driving in the area.
The news continues. Just before the announcer was found dead, she was apparently staying at the Amagi Inn run by Yukiko's family. And it seems the whereabouts of Saki Konishi, who discovered the body, are unknown.
Is the ramen ready now?
Give it some more time.
You sneezed. You feel a slight chill.
Are you sick? You're probably still adjusting to the new environment. Nanako, could you get him some cold medicine?
No, I just entered the TV and saw a bear and he talked to me. There was a lot of fog. It was cold.
You should get to bed after you take it.
You're not my dad. People who are sick should stay in bed. There's fog today, so you should go to sleep early or you'll catch cold. It's too late. I already have a cold. Ha ha! You should go straight to bed tonight. A spring cold can be tough. Thank you, game, characters, NPCs. That's where my mind was going. You feel sluggish. You should rest early today. Sure. Friday.
Oh, you're up. Well, I'm off.
Dojiba left the house.
Dad has to go do something. He got a call, so he left.
Nanako looks worried. She always looks worried. You can hear girls gossiping.
When I looked, I saw three police cars zooming by. You live by the police station, don't you? Did you hear anything? I heard some yelling, but nothing more. A total disappointment.
Jeez, you need to pay more attention to stuff like that. How else are we supposed to get the juicy stories?
You hear sirens nearby. It seems there's been an incident. You decide to head to school. I guess in a rural town like this, a juicy story is the best thing
hey,
they can get.
Did you see it yesterday? Of course not. What is that rumor for real? I don't know, but it seems like a lot of people have seen it.
You overhear people gossiping about something.
Yukiko said she'd be here after lunch. I wonder why they're holding a school assembly all of a sudden.
Hey, what's wrong, Yosuke?
Oh, it's nothing.
Everyone, please settle down. The school assembly is about to begin. First, the principal has something to say.
I regret to say that I have a terrible announcement for all of you. One of our third-year students, Ms. Saki Konishi of Class 3, has passed away.
Passed away?
Ms. Konishi was found deceased early this morning. The reasons behind her passing are currently under investigation by the police. If they ask you for your cooperation, I urge you, as students of this school, to provide only the facts.
Senpai's
here?
About that,
oh,
right?
I saw it too.
All right, please quiet down. I have been assured by the faculty that there's been no evidence that bullying was involved in the incident. So mind what you say, not only to the police, but to anyone who asks.
Found dead? How could this happen?
The principal's address continues, but we don't get to hear it. What a shame.
She died the same way as that announcer, right? It's so creepy.
Well, last time it was from an antenna, but this time she was hanging from a telephone pole. It's gotta be a serial murder case.
Someone said the cause of death was some unknown poison.
Unknown? Come on, this isn't some sci-fi drama. Oh, by the way, did you hear? Someone saw a girl that looked like Saki on that Midnight Channel thingy. They said she totally looked like she was in pain. Isn't that scary?
Sounds like someone had a nightmare. The media's been broadcasting their interviews with her nonstop. So maybe they just had Saki on the brain.
Sheesh. It's easy to toss around theories if you're not personally involved.
I was about to say the same thing. It's very heartless considering she's a classmate. Well, no. She's a third year. But she's a schoolmate, so there. She's part of the student body.
Hey, did you guys check out the TV last night?
Yosuke, not you too!
Just listen for a sec. Something kept bothering me, so I watched it again, and I think the girl on the screen was Saki-senpai. There's no mistaking it. Senpai looked like she was writhing in pain, and then she disappeared from the screen.
What?
You heard Senpai's body was found in a similar situation as that announcer's, right? Oh, remember that guy you told us about? How he was all excited that his soulmate was the announcer? Maybe, just maybe, but Ms. Yamano might have been on that Midnight Channel before she died too.
What's that supposed to mean? Hold on. Are you saying people who appear on that TV die?
I can't say for sure, but something tells me. I just can't dismiss it as coincidence. Plus, remember what that bear thing said? How that place was dangerous and we should leave before the fog clears? It also said that someone's been throwing people in there. And that room with the posters on the wall, it has to have something to do with the announcer's death. I mean, don't you think there's some kind of connection there?
Do we ever hear anything about Mizuzu Hiragi after this?
Couldn't that world in the TV have something to do with Senpai and the announcer's death? Well, what do you think?
You might be right.
So it's not just me, huh? If there is a connection, then it's a good bet that the two of them went inside that world. That would explain the posters in that room. Which means, if we look around, we might find a place that has something to do with Senpai, too.
Yosuke, don't tell me.
Yeah. I'm thinking about going in again. I want to find out for myself.
Don't do this! You should just let the police handle this and...
You think we can rely on the police? They haven't made any progress on the announcer's case. Besides, even if we told them about the world inside the TV, there's no way they're gonna believe us. If I'm completely off base with this, that's fine. It's just, I need to know why Senpai had to die like this.
Yosuke.
After what I've seen and what I've put together, there's no way I can ignore it now. Sorry, but you're the only person who can help me. I'm gonna go get ready. I'll be waiting for you at Juness.
Yosuke has asked you to take him into the TV world again.
I can kinda understand how he feels, but we can't be sure we'll be able to get out safely again. What should we do?
Go with Yosuke.
You serious? Anyways, let's go to Juness. We can't leave Yosuke alone.
Away! Would you... Jeez, that just came out of nowhere. Kind of startled me a little bit. Yeah, sure. How many saves do I have? It stops at 16 for some reason.
You guys came.
We came to stop you, idiot. Come on, you really shouldn't do this. It's too dangerous.
I know, but we were able to come back once, right? If we go in from the same location, maybe we'll meet that bear again.
Maybe isn't good enough.
Look, I can't just act like everyone else and pretend this has nothing to do with me.
That's true, but...
What about you? Could you just walk away?
I can't leave it alone. This doesn't involve me. I'm worried about Chie. I can't leave it alone.
Yeah, I thought not. I'm glad to know you're that kind of guy. Don't worry, I'm not going in without a plan. Chie, I'm leaving you in charge of this.
Huh? What's that? A rope?
We'll go in with this tied to me. So I want you to hold on to this and wait here.
What? Then this is a lifeline? Come on, wait a sec.
Here, this is for you.
Dude, a golf club? And medicine.
I thought it might be better than going in empty-handed. Alright, let's go. There's no use wasting any more time. Chie, whatever you do, don't let go of the rope.
Hey! I said wait!
No, we're just gonna go inside. It's fine. This will be fun.
Is this? Look, this is the same place as last time. So they are connected from place to place.
You guys, why'd you come back? I get it. You're the ones behind this.
You're that thing from last time. Wait, what the hell did you just say?
Lately, I can tell someone's been throwing people in here. It's making this world more and more messed up. This is the second time you guys came here, and I don't think anyone forced you in. That means you're the most suspicious. You guys must be the ones throwing the people in here.
Very ferocious. Hell no!
What are you talking about, throwing people in? If someone was thrown in here and they couldn't get out, they might die. Who would do such a... Wait a sec. All this talk about someone throwing people in here, does he mean Senpai and the announcer? Did that someone throw those two in here? Hey, what do you think?
Yeah, that must be it.
Yeah, I agree. Let's assume he's telling the truth. Could it be that someone's throwing people in here, intending to kill them? If that's the case...
What are you guys mumbling about? Why'd you come here anyways? It's a one-way door. You can't get out once you're in. Remember how I had to let you guys out?
Yeah, whatever. We don't need your help this time. See? This time we have a lifeline. What? Hey! You better let us out once we're done investigating here.
I'm the one who wants to investigate. I've lived here for a long time, but it's never been noisy like this till now. Do you have proof? Prove to me you're not throwing people in here.
It doesn't work that way.
See? So it is you guys.
For the last time, it's not us. So we've got nothing to prove to you. Hey, you better answer our questions. This isn't like last time when we came by accident. We're dead serious. Listen up, because people have died in our world. Every time the fog appears, a dead body shows up with it. It has to be related to this place somehow. If you know something, tell us.
A dead body? Whenever the fog appears? I know that if it's foggy on your side, the fog lifts here. It's really dangerous when the fog lifts. That's when the shadows get violent. Ah, I get it.
Huh? If you get it, then explain it to us, damn it! If it's foggy on our side, it isn't in here, shadows get violent?
That's why I said to hurry back. It's dangerous when that happens. Okay, no more questions. I know you guys did it. You better stop right now!
I've told you and told you we're not the ones doing it. I've about had it with you. Why the hell won't you listen to what we're saying?
I'm just saying, you might be the culprits. I'm just making sure.
What? Man, this bear's driving me nuts. What is this place anyways? It looks like a TV studio. Is something being filmed here? Hey, don't tell me. Is that weird show being filmed here?
Weird show? Filmed? What does that mean?
I'm asking if someone's been filming the people that get thrown in here.
Eh? I don't get it. This world has always been like this. No one has ever done that filming thing here. Only me and Shadows are here. I told you before!
We don't know what these shadow things are, or what you are either, for that matter. You keep telling us to prove our innocence, but you're the most suspicious thing here. Maybe you're the real culprit. And what's with that stupid costume? I'd say it's time you showed your face! Whoa!
I think this is a good time to end the video. Thank you for watching. Sincerely hope that you enjoyed the video, that you're having a great day, and, whoa, my brain just shut off completely. That you're staying safe, wearing masks whenever possible when you go out. And next time, more of this! It's more of the- more of me being tired and playing a game in my tiredness. Okay, bye!